Necessary and sufficient conditions is the topic of the 10th theory session of the problem solving test course. We will learn what a critical factor is, discuss the concept, and learn how to identify it in test questions. Here's an interesting example from an official PST. You might want to pause the video now and try to solve the question on your own. Which of the following statements is accurate regarding the Geller's bid for additional funding? A. If the Geller has provided economic benefit to Riverside, it will receive additional funding from the Arts Council. Economic benefit results in funding. B. If the Geller has not provided social benefit to Riverside, it will not receive additional funding from the Arts Council. C. If the Geller has not provided economic benefit to Riverside, it will not receive additional funding from the Arts Council. If the Geller has provided social benefit to Riverside, it will not receive additional funding from the Arts Council. We look at the text and learn what is important for getting that funding. From the text, we learn that the Geller's management, in order to get funding, will need to prove to the Arts Council that the Geller is benefiting the local area of Riverside. And it needs to benefit in two ways, economic and social. We also learn that economic benefit to Riverside is the critical factor that will determine whether or not they will receive additional funding. Critical factor is the necessary condition. A necessary condition means that lack of necessary condition brings lack of result. In other words, no economic benefit means no funding. And this is exactly what they say in option C. So option C is right. Let us have a look at necessary and sufficient conditions in more detail. Necessary conditions. Condition A is necessary for condition B means that absence of A results in absence of B. Equivalently, it means that presence of B is possible only if A is present. It does not mean that presence of B results in presence of A because some other conditions might be necessary. Words such as critical, vital, essential, imperative, obligatory, and so on are indicators of necessary conditions. Let's consider this hypothetical statement, which is of course not 100% true in reality. Having an MBA is a necessary condition for an associate position at McKinsey. Based on this statement, we can conclude that if you do not have an MBA, you will not become an associate at McKinsey. If you have an MBA, you might still not become an associate, probably because there are other factors at play. But if you got an associate position, you must have had an MBA. This is how necessary conditions work. Now, sufficient conditions. Condition A is sufficient for condition B, means that presence of A will guarantee presence of B. Equivalently, it means that absence of B is possible only if A is absent. It does not mean that absence of A results in absence of B. Maybe some other condition is enough, not just condition A. Indicators of sufficient conditions are words like enough, to assure, to ensure, to guarantee, to lead to. Continuing our hypothetical McKinsey story, let us have a look at the following example. MBA with distinction from Harvard guarantees an associate position at McKinsey. Based on this statement, we can conclude that if you have an MBA with distinction from Harvard, you will get an associate position at McKinsey. If you don't, you still might get it, but most probably other conditions will apply. And if you did not get an associate position with McKinsey, you had not received an MBA with distinction from Harvard either. So much for sufficient conditions. Take a moment to think which option is an accurate statement now. This time we noticed that proven economic benefit to Riverside is a sufficient, not necessary, condition for funding. That means that presence of economic benefit will lead to additional funding. And this is exactly what option A is saying now. And this time, option A is accurate. Let us synthesize what we have learned today. A necessary condition is a must-have for achieving a certain result. However, it might not be enough. A sufficient condition, on the contrary, is enough for achieving a certain result. However, it might not be a must-have. Once again, have a look at the indicator words and make sure to notice them in the actual PST. That's all for today. Please leave your questions and observations in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and until next time.